I can confidently say that Zambia definitely can eliminate cancer of the cervix. Cervical cancer is the most common cancer that we have in Zambia. Women presenting with cancer of the cervix in Zambia, diagnosis is done in the age ranges between 30 to 45 commonly. That means that women are coming in with cancer of the cervix in the prime of their lives when they are contributing to this nation economically, socially and culturally as well. Over 50% of the cases that they saw, women were coming in with stage 4, which is the last stage of cancer. Women who are living with HIV are 5, sometimes even up to 7 times likely to develop cancer of the cervix. We end up losing a woman from a preventable disease. We end up having lost a woman who has consistently taken her medication because we didn't prevent her from getting cancer of the cervix.
Even me, I used to admire to see people smiling. I would say, am I ever going to smile again? It robbed me of all my happiness, all my life. It was just terrible.
This is a disease which is highly preventable. Therefore, we shouldn't lose women in their prime contributing to this nation. That is why we need to ensure that this disease is eliminated.
Can Zambia eliminate cervical cancer? Sure it can, through educating its women and educating men to the importance of cervical cancer screening, letting them know that it's not a death sentence, that it is something that can be prevented in an office. It takes 10 minutes to get rid of a precancer.
When we look at the cultural issues that we have to deal with, sexual reproductive health in our society is something that we don't discuss openly. So we have to break the taboos that go with women talking openly about their sexual reproductive health. You will find that the symptoms that are seen, there is a cultural explanation that the women actually have.
Unfortunately, all the people that I talked to, all my friends, all they could tell me was, no, Lois, you've been bewitched. And I bought it.
So the first place they are going to go to is the witch doctor, because they are the ones who fix such things. And in all these pathways to treatment, we're losing time. And because we lose time, women present late. It's the availability of services. Issues of geographical inability for the woman to be able to go and get screened. So we have two populations. We have the urban, we have the rural area. 64% of women in Zambia live in the rural area. And 80% of the women that are living in the rural area are producers of food. In Zambia, we still have largely an extended type of family, and a woman is the cornerstone of that extended family. And when you remove the centerpiece of a family, it means that the children are affected in terms of their education, in who they can be. And this has been shown in research that there is an impact when a woman dies on the children failing to become who they were supposed to be. The potential is reduced when we lose a woman.
For every woman who dies of cervical or breast cancer in a country like Zambia, up to 15 to 20 children also die. It shows you the impact of the woman in that society. So it's not just her children, it's the children in her halo, her sister's children, her children's children, which shows you what influence women have in protecting children, making sure they get vaccinations, making sure they try to get clean water. If you take a woman out of this society, the whole thing collapses.
And that is why it is important to eliminate it. We know what we can do. We know how it can be done. So there is no need to lose women to this disease. The Zambia Cervical Cancer Screening Program was started in 2006. So this program started with 2 clinics in the capital. This program now has close to 160 clinics all over this country. And we are seeing close to 300,000 women coming in annually getting their first screen in their lives.
Cervical cancer is deadly. It is terrible. I had stopped socializing. I could not go anywhere because you never know when I'll start bleeding. Let everyone, signs or no signs, go to the clinic and have yourself screened, because this is how you're going to know.
For us to talk about elimination, we're talking about women getting screened, and we're talking about HPV vaccination. Zambia started the HPV vaccination in 2013, and over 50,000 girls got vaccinated from 2013 to about 2016, which was a great milestone for the nation. Over the next 5 years, we must ensure we are having 90% of these girls getting vaccinated, that we ensure that over 70% of these women are getting screened, ensure that women are getting treated. What Zambia has done basically shows that it can be done by any of the low-income countries. Conquering cancer means improved care. Conquering cancer means a world with women who are empowered and they're not succumbing to a disease and unable to give their full potential to their families, to this nation.